Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back. My name is Nadia Sands. This, of course, is Learn How to Edit Stuff. And today, we are doing a visual effects breakdown of this scene from my Art Grid video editing contest submission. It's pretty cool. A lot of intricate little things going on here. Camera movement, reflections, all that kind of stuff. It's going to be a really fun video. We're doing it all in After Effects today. And it's guaranteed to be a pretty good time. Now, for those of you that are returning subscribers, returning viewers, yes, the room I'm in is now different. I have moved to a new location, which is why I've kind of been missing from YouTube for the past couple weeks. Moving with a baby and a dog is very stressful when you're an adult. And so that's why I was gone. So I apologize for that. But we're bringing the heat on this visual effects breakdown video for my Art Grid video editing contest submission. And if you guys don't know what the Art Grid video editing contest is, I will leave a link down in the video description below. But basically, you have to edit together either an ad spot, a music video, or a movie trailer using only stock footage from Art Grid and only stock music from Art List. And I decided to submit myself this year because I wanted the challenge. You have until September 23rd to do it for yourself, but that's on you. Today we're gonna do a visual effects breakdown from a scene from my video. Here's that scene again. And basically the plot of my music video is there's a guy who's like super, you know, sad about an ex-girlfriend and he's remembering her. And so he's looking in the reflection of this window and he's seeing kind of like old memories play out and it kind of burns out in a film burn. So we're gonna do that today. Pretty technical. We're doing some camera tracking. We're doing some rotoscoping, some blending and some mapping. It's gonna be really fun. It's gonna be super exciting. I'm excited, you're excited. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up if you are excited to learn some visual effects today, and drop a comment in the comment section below and let me know how fast you think I talk. You know, I love hearing those. It's because I like coffee a lot. Okay, we're opening up Adobe After Effects and we are getting started right now. All right, boys and girls, down in my timeline, I have two video clips. One is the guy looking in the reflection of this window, and the other, which is muted right now, is the shot of the old memory of him kind of like swinging his girl around. And so basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna put this video clip in the reflection of this video. Now you can see it's kind of skewed off center, which is gonna make it really fun and challenging for us, but not really because you've got your old pal. No, okay, we're not, okay. Anyway, so we're gonna start off by coming up to layer and creating a new null object, because this is where we're going to place our, hit the enter key, tracking data. It's always good to label your layers. So basically we're going to track this VFX shot here. So we're gonna come over to our tracker on the right-hand side of Adobe After Effects. And if you don't have this, you can come up to window and go to tracker here, or you can come to workspace all panels and it will put all of these panels over here. But basically you're trying to navigate to the tracker panel and click on track motion. And how this works is an area, you're supposed to track an area of high and low contrast. And I try to never track the subject unless I'm gonna be putting something on the subject, because the subject moves a lot more than our camera. So basically a good way to do this is to find something in the reflection that's both high and low contrast. So I'm going to track this big kind of orange hot dog thing on our mirror. I'm gonna put my tracker right around this orange hot dog. And this is the area in which you want to track, and the outside square is the area that's kind of looking for that information. And because my camera doesn't move too much, we shouldn't have a problem tracking this nicely. So before we hit track, let's go to edit target, and let's target our tracking data, which I now realize says tracking date, but hey, we're already deep into the tutorial. So tracking date, click okay, and now we are just going to track forward. And it's gonna track my orange hot dog right in that reflection. And this is the tracking data that we're gonna use to kind of parent our footage to, so the footage follows the movement of the camera. We are now done, and all we have to do is click apply, apply dimensions X and Y, and now it will apply all of that tracking data to our null object. You can see here the position keyframes are all set up and ready for us to go, which is fantastic. So now what I'm gonna do is come over to the beginning of my composition, and I'm going to click on my VFX shot here. And I'm actually going to pre-comp this by hitting Shift-Control-C on my keyboard, and I'm going to move all attributes to a new composition. And now what I'm gonna do is add corner pins to this pre-comp. I have the Video Copilot effects console, so I can hit Control and Spacebar to search for any effect in After Effects. I highly recommend it. It's a very fast way to kind of like get stuff done. It's a free plugin from Video Copilot, link in the video description. Fantastic plugin. Anyway, what we're gonna do now is just kind of corner pin. And I'm gonna turn the opacity down by hitting T so we can actually see what we're doing. And basically we're gonna try to match the dimensions of this window. So you can see that there's a hard line for us to kind of follow right here, which is really nice. So I'm just gonna kind of corner pin this to the best of my ability, and I'm gonna overlap that line, and I'll show you why in just a minute, but I'm gonna kind of overlap the line. I'm gonna quarter pin this to the best of my ability, and I have to kind of imagine where the window goes, but because we're on sort of a like weird skewed angle, something like this would work. It's kind of like a sideways rhombus situation, which is totally fine. But basically, what I want to do now is kind of move the footage into his eye line, because right now it's kind of like in a weird spot. So what I'm going to do is just kind of move this over here to his eye line so that he's looking at the memory, and this perspective kind of makes sense now. So now the last thing I'm going to do is pick whip this pre-comp to our tracking date, and now that footage will kind of follow the camera movement very nicely. So now our footage is tracked to the scene and everything's looking real good. And now the next thing I'm gonna do is add a mask to my footage so I can follow this line right here. So with that pre-comp selected, I'm gonna double click on my mask button up here, boop, boop. And it will automatically add a mask to my video. You can't see it right now because the little mask overlay is toggled off, but now you can see that mask nice and pretty. And what I'm gonna do is set a mask path keyframe, and I'm gonna move this mask to line up with this hard line in the window. Okay, and we're at frame one, by the way. So kind of line it up there real nice. Then I'm gonna come to 1 second and I'm gonna do it again and just adjust the mask a little bit so it stays within the bounds of that window. And I'm gonna come all the way over to the end and do the same thing. And just make sure that we're following this nice hard line in the window. And then the last thing I will do is feather that mask so it kind of blends a little bit more with that side of the window. And now the mask is kind of animating along with the camera, and we have a nice feathered edge along that side of the window. So now when I turn my opacity back up, you can see a couple of things are happening here, right? We're gonna have to roto his face and his hand so it's going over this footage. And we're also gonna have to make the footage look like a reflection. And my favorite blend mode in After Effects, thank you for asking, I'm sure you're curious, is color dodge for reflections. My favorite blend mode for reflections is color dodge. So we can come in here and go to our mode. And if you don't see this mode in After Effects, you can toggle and switch modes down here at the bottom, which should pop up with that mode. And now we can change this to color dodge. Looks pretty good. And we could also maybe try classic color dodge, which is actually giving us a nicer edge here on the window, but I like color dodge normal. So we're gonna go with color dodge. And the reason I like it is because we can still see the original reflections that are in the reflection, as well as making this look like a reflection. And it's gonna really look like a reflection when we hit T. I'm gonna turn this all the way to zero so we can see our original reflections of his hand and his face here. And I'm gonna slowly kind of turn it up to the point where we're not losing his reflection completely, but we're still seeing this reflection. So right about 43%, but I like even numbers. So we're gonna go to 42%, and that's looking good. So the next thing we're gonna do is rotoscope out his hand and his entire side of his face here so that our reflection layer isn't going over his skin, because that doesn't look right. It has to be behind him in Z depth or whatever. So I have tutorials on the RotoBrush 2 tool that you can watch. I have tutorials on Runway ML that you can watch, but what I don't have is a tutorial on Mocha Pro, which I've been really actually using a lot lately, specifically for the mesh tracking feature, which I'm gonna demo today in this tutorial. Mocha AE, you can do a lot of tracking and cool stuff with there. I have some tutorials on that as well, but I've never done a tutorial on Mocha Pro. So welcome to the mini tutorial about Mocha Pro. I'm going to duplicate my bottom clip and drag it up onto top here. And I'm going to search for Mocha Pro and drop Mocha Pro right on that piece of video. Click on the Mocha icon, which will launch, you guessed it, Mocha Pro. So basically what I'm gonna do inside of Mocha Pro, and it works very much like Mocha AE. I'm not gonna do a tutorial on every little, nook and cranny of this thing. But basically we're gonna take our pen tool and zoom in here. And I'm just gonna trace the outside of my actor. There we go, actor trace complete, and you can see a nice little line around here. And I'm kind of cutting him off halfway down the body because we actually don't need to do everything, and why make your computer work harder than it has to? But anyway, now that I've got this traced, what I'm gonna do is come right down here to the bottom under our little like track, metrics down here, and I'm gonna click on mesh, which is going to actually track a moving mesh inside of Mocha Pro, which is really cool, and it will add all these other little points and stuff. And what I would recommend doing for doing human beings or things that are like really like kind of fluid, when I think of mesh, I think of like that kind of thing, is that my cool dance moves, like and subscribe, thumbs up for the... Okay, so basically I want to make this a uniform mesh and not this kind of like hodgepodge mesh that it just automatically generates. So down here under generation mode, I'm going to switch this from automatic to uniform, then click generate mesh. And as you'll see, it generates a grid of a mesh, and that's going to be a much better track for us in the end. And you can change the mesh size by kind of rotating this down. Maybe we'll do a 24 mesh size, and then you have to regenerate the mesh every time. So that looks like pretty good track points. I'm actually going to go a little bit lower. Let's go to 20, generate mesh. That's looking really great. And then all you have to do, guys, is just track this forward. Okay, it has reached the end of my clip, and I realized that I started from the middle of the clip. You can see this little green arrow here. So now I'm going to go to my green arrow and just track backwards from there. Okay, great. Once you are done with your track, all you have to do is click Control S to save all of that data inside of Mocha Pro, close Mocha Pro, and now I can come up to Matte and I can click on this little button that says Create AE Masks, and it will automatically mask out that footage based on my data from Mocha Pro. I'm going to solo this layer so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. And now I have a mask inside of After Effects like I'm used to seeing, and it's all tracked, keyframed, every single frame, and now I just have a mask and footage that I can work with. So I'm going to come in here and zoom in, and I'm just going to feather this. How much? I'm going to feather this 6 pixels. That's looking pretty good to me. And now when I come in here, I can unsolo this. Now we have our actor's face outside of our reflection layer, and now this looks a lot more believable in the grand scheme of things. So we're gonna do the exact same thing with his hand. All right, and there we go. We have successfully rotoed out our actor, his hand and his face, and he is now looking at the reflection of his past life with his girl that he lost, and we're getting somewhere. This is looking really, really awesome. So now the last thing that I wanna do is just really kind of button up this reflection a little bit more, since this is looking good, and then we'll add the film burn effect as the memory kind of burns away. This is art school, kids. Well, I don't know what to tell you. So now, because we pre-comped this layer, it's gonna make it a little bit easier for us to do these effects. So first off, I'm gonna add a fast box blur to our reflection because it is way too in focus. I'm gonna change this blur amount to 4, and that's gonna give it a nice blur on our reflection there, and that's looking really nice. And then what we'll do is double click into our pre-comp, and then this is where we can add our film burn. Now, I like to use an adjustment layer, and I like to use the I like to use the Boris FX Continuum Burnt Film. It is part of the Boris FX Continuum plugin set. You guys probably don't have that, but I'm gonna demo this, and I'm also gonna demo how to do it with a matte as well, which is free. You can find a bunch of those mats online, but I like the Boris FX Continuum, all of it, and Sapphire, all of it's great. All the Boris FX stuff is great. So basically what I'm gonna do is come over here and turn the animation to percent done. And then I'm gonna come to right about here where I want it to start, and I'm gonna change the percent done amount to 0, and then I'm gonna go all the way to the end of our clip and change the percent done amount to 100. So now we kind of have this like film burn kind of like happening out here. And I can change the shape of this under the shape slider. So now we have this thing kind of burning from the outsides in. And now when we click back over into our visual effect, you can see here that the film burn is burning away his memory. And if I had to be really nitpicky with this, I would say to go in and kind of adjust the mask here on our feather, which we can do very easily by just turning the mask expansion down so that it's not hitting that hard line, as you see. And that's looking pretty good. So let's play this, looking at the old memories, and then it burns away. Wow, art. But as I said earlier in the tutorial, this is very technical. There's a lot going on here with the tracking and the rotoing and the reflection and the corner pin. So if you followed along, congratulations. I am super, super proud of you. We've been going for quite some time now. This is kind of a long tutorial, but I think it's gonna be worth it. Real quick, if you don't have the Boris FX Continuum stuff, let's just pop open that composition there. Let's delete that. And I went and pulled a set of burn film transitions off of Envato Elements. I will put a link specifically down here to the one that I pulled, but that is just a nice little burn film element right there. And all we have to do with this, with a matte, is apply set matte to this layer, turn it from alpha channel to luminance. And now you can see that we have a nice little growing matte, and then click on our video underneath and set the track matte to alpha inverted matte, which will now burn it away into alpha land, just like that. So I'm gonna start it a little bit later down here, maybe at 1 second, and it burns away, just like so. Now when we go back to our visual effects shot, we have the same thing happening here. It just doesn't have the pretty colors around the burnt edges, but this kind of looks like Venom, kind of like weird Stranger Things darkness creeping in. So whatever, pick your poison here, kiddos, but that's how you do this tutorial. This is the steps that I took to do this effect in the video that I haven't released yet that I'm gonna be putting on my channel for the Art Grid 2021 Edit Challenge. I challenge you to enter the editing challenge, which you do have until September 23rd to submit your entry. 30-second ad spot, movie trailer, or music video, pick your poison. You can go and sign up for free on ArtGrid and just use watermarked footage to make your entry. But I would recommend doing it even if you don't submit, because it really is a challenging topic to do the edit on. And I had a lot of fun with this, and I can't wait for you guys to see my video, which I'll be posting probably sometime in the middle of the week, Wednesday maybe. So be on the lookout for that. Anyways, man, I like to ramble. I hope you guys had fun during this tutorial. A lot of complicated, cool little things happening in After Effects here. So I'm hoping that you learned something new today in one of the processes. And if you want to use Mocha Pro, I'll put a link down in the video description below for you to check out Mocha Pro. If you've never used Mocha in general, Mocha AE is free inside of After Effects. So I would recommend playing around with that. And yeah, we did some cool stuff today. Make sure you throw a comment in the comment section below, a thumbs up on this video, smash that subscribe button. I moved into my new place now, so be prepared for more videos from your boy Naughty and Sans now that I'm all moved. We're having some fun with this stuff. I think I'm out of things to say. Oh, Linktree link in the video description below as well if you guys want to support me, support yourself. There's a lot of cool goodies down there and ways to support your boy, my social media, all that stuff. Contribute to my coffee addiction by picking up Envato Elements or a subscription to Epidemic Sound or AE Juice, all the good stuff. A small portion of that goes to me, and I use that small portion to fund my caffeine addiction. It is an addiction for sure at this point. All right, that's it for me. I will see you in the next one.